everyone, welcome back to my channel. You're tuned in to Wedge Flower, and on this channel I do soap making videos and entrepreneur series. So if you're new and you like those kind of videos, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can be notified whenever I post a new video. And if you're an old subscriber, thank you so much for tuning in again and watching my videos. Today we're going to be talking about equipments that you need to start your own soap making journey, if you want to turn it into a business or if you're just doing it for a hobby. So I'm going to show you some of the equipments that I use to make my soaps. And you can find most of these things on Amazon or Etsy. You know, you can find them anywhere, basically wherever is the cheapest price, and you can actually make some of these things. So I'm going to show you guys some of the equipment that I have. I'm going to start with the first thing I used when I first started making soaps. Some people start using a shoebox or whatever kind of, I guess, container that could be molded. You are good to go. I started using this rectangular mold that I have here. I actually have four of these. This was my first mold, and I got this from Amazon. It comes with these little cutter knives that you can use to cut your soaps if you don't have one. So those were very useful. The next big purchase that I made, once you start really, really learning how to make the soaps and you start to get good at it, you can upgrade to a bigger mold or make your own mold. So I got this mold over here. I got this mold. It holds three of these. So it holds three of these rectangular molds. Okay, so this holds 126 ounces of soap. So one of the things that I like to do to keep the silicone mold long lasting and nice and soaky, I like to apply Vaseline on the bottom so that the soap doesn't ruin the mold. That's one of the little tricks that I used. But yeah, this is a 42 ounce mold. It came with this cutter, because once you put the soap in that big mold, You're gonna need to cut it in loaves. This comes as one loaf, so you're gonna have to cut it in loaf, and this helps you to cut it in big loaves. I already adjusted the string to the size that I like, but I really like this little handy dandy tool, and it is an easy clean. It's like a plastic, a really, really dirty plastic, and the wiring. But yeah, that soap cutter, also from Etsy. It's a stainless steel, so it's easy clean, and it's really gonna last a long time. So yeah, it's from Soap Cutter Pro. It's a Soap Cutter Pro. It's not from Soap Cutter Pro. It's a Soap Cutter Pro. It cuts 12 bars, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It cuts 11 bars of soap, and I customized mine for it to be 1.5 inch, so 1.5 inches. That's my spacing on the soap cutter. It's a little dirty right now because I just cut some soaps earlier. But yeah, and you're gonna need a measurement. If you don't have a soap cutter that already has a measurement, please get a measurement so you will know how thick you want the soaps to be, so all of them are uniformed and alike. I also got some extra wires for my soap cutter in case the other one breaks, because sometimes the soaps could be a little, you know, hard to cut. So you need a soap cutter. This actually came with the soap mold, the big blue soap mold that I have. That's what it came with. Yeah, so those are all my soap equipment. I won't link where I got it from, but you can definitely look them up on Amazon and Etsy and other places. There's a lot of places that sell these if you're interested in any of these soaps. But yeah, that'll be all for my video. I hope you enjoy it, and if you did, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.